It's so easy to change the atmosphere of your 3D comp using image-based lighting. But what about applying effects to 3D objects? Well, this is a less straightforward process, but still doable. Want to see how? Well, just sit back and enjoy. So I'm working in this composition that I already started to animate using the same principles that I've showed you in the previous tutorial. Link is down below. Let me quickly break down the layers that we have here. By the way, all the models that you are seeing here can be downloaded from sketchfab.com. So the first one is this futuristic city, and then we have the Batman Lego, which is parented to the Batwing, of course, and this Batwing air combat vehicle, as well as the camera, are animated to add some drama and interest to this comp. Now, to tell a short story, there are also two additional objects here on the roof of the building, the backlight and spotlight, which are parented and animated. Now, the reason that I've separated the spot will be cleared later down the line, so wait for it. Next, I've placed several point lights in key positions, one on top of the rooftop, another one on top of the backlight, a third point light is above the Batman figure, and it's parented to the Batman Lego model, of course, because after all, he's our hero and we want to see him at all times. Lastly, the main light here is an environment light, which is also responsible for casting shadows. And to see those shadows, I'll need to switch off Draft 3D and move around to, let's say, 4 seconds. So, this is with the shadows, and this is without the shadows. And again, I covered all of these techniques in the previous tutorial that explains how to work with the new 3D workspace, so make sure to watch it if you want to know more. For now, I'll turn back the Draft 3D mode because I want to work quickly and explore a few ways to relight the scene using an HDRI image. Before I get to the light section, I wish to add a panoramic cityscape background instead of this black dark void. And to do it, I'll use one of the images under the HDRI folder that I have here, and this one, the Night Skyline 4K, is part of the Video Copilot Metropolitan Pack. And it's going to be a perfect background element, but we need to make sure that it will respond to the 3D camera that we have in this composition. So I'll close the footage viewer, and I'll drag and drop it to the composition underneath all of the layers. To make it respond to the 3D camera that we have, I'll go to Effect, and from the Perspective category, I'll add the CC Environment effect, which is going to map it around a sphere. And you have a few other options, but spherical will work perfect in this case. To see more of the building, I can change the lens distortion. So let's set it to 40. And of course, we can also use the horizontal pan to move to a different section. So I'll start by changing this to, let's say, -7. Now, if I'll grab the playhead and move, you can see that this is playing really nicely with the 3D elements that we have. But of course, it is just a 2D layer with a 3D aware effect applied. Okay, so now we can go back to the project panel and we are ready to use a real HDRI image to light those 3D objects. And as I mentioned briefly in the previous tutorial, you can use a 360-degree high dynamic range image, also known as HDRI files, as a light source to realistically place models into the scene with a complementary lighting and shadows, making it look like the objects are actually there naturally. So I already imported 4 HDRI images. 3 of them are from Adobe Stock. So I'll double click to show you. This is one of them, this is the second, and this is the third. And the last one is from Polyhaven, which is one of the best free online resources, not only for HDRIs, but also for textures and 3D models. The link is down below. So I'll select all of these images and I'll drag and drop them underneath everything. And I'm also going to switch off the visibility for them because I'm just going to use them as a source to light the scene. And to do it, I'll need to return back to the environment light. I'll twirl it up, and then under its light options, under source, I can access all the other HDR images that I have in this composition. So this is the default HDRI light that comes with After Effects. This is how it looks. I'll move the playhead to, let's say, over here, 4 seconds, and then I'll switch to the Blue Photo Studio 4K, which is going to give us this result. Let's try another one. And each one of them is going to affect everything in the scene. All the 3D objects are going to use the same HDRI image, which makes them look very natural and realistic. Now, you can also open up the transform of the light and play with the X and Y rotation, effectively changing the way the sphere is positioned in the scene. So we can change the X rotation, and as you can see, this is the influence, as well as the Y rotation, to maybe pick a more interesting angle from the same texture. And this is a general settings, so if I'll return to one of the other HDR images, you can see how this works, so you can really tweak it until you find something that looks interesting and appropriate to what you are trying to convey. So in this case, I think that I'm going to select the green option, which is this one, and let's start by resetting the X and Y rotation. And of course, this will only impact your 3D models in this composition. So if you are using it in conjunction with a 2D layer, as we are in this case, you need to somehow match those colors to the other layers. So I'll reselect the background layer that I'm using for the cityscape. And let's just go to the beginning, just so we can see it a little bit clearer. And to match the colors, I'll go to Effect, Color Correction, and I'll use the Color Link effect. For the source layer, I'll select the same image that I'm using for the environment light, which is this guy, and I'll sample the average colors, but I'll change the blending mode to something different. Usually, soft light is going to give you a nice starting point, but of course you have other blending modes to choose from. So now everything looks like it is living in the same world. Now I want to apply a few effects that I think will help to tell a better story. But unfortunately, the new advanced 3D renderer will not allow us to use effects directly on 3D objects. If you want to see the full list of pros and cons, you can visit the composition settings by pressing Ctrl or Command K. And here on the third tab, you have a list of what's enabled and what's disabled for this renderer. However, this is After Effects, so there must be a way to apply these effects to these layers. And there is, but it's kind of a hack or a workaround, depending on how you want to call it. So let me show you how this works. So I'll close the Composition Settings dialog. And in this case, I want to create light streaks that are coming out of this bat spot to mimic the iconic comics imagery. And this is the reason that I've separated the spot from the light based. But again, I can't apply effects directly to this layer as the entire effect menu is dimmed. So instead, I'm going to go to the layer menu and I'll create a new solid. I'll name this solid light rays. Make sure it is set to the comp size and click OK. And since the bat spot layer was selected, the solid is now above it, which is very important. We need to make sure that this is not breaking the 3D bin structure. So as you can see over here, all the 3D objects are inside the same group. Okay, so now to this layer, I'll go to the effect menu, and from the channel category, I'll apply the calculations effect. Now, you can also use the CC composite, which is just one floor underneath. But I found that the calculations effect render a little bit faster, at least on my machine. I will show you another example of how to use the CC composite later in this tutorial, so stay tuned for that. But for now, let's apply the calculations effect. So in case you haven't used it before, I'll right-click on the name, and then I'll ask After Effects to tell us all about this effect. And as you can see, this one performs arithmetic operations using source and input layer channels, meaning that we can set a second source as a 3D object and it will render it as a regular 2D layer. So to demonstrate this, the second layer in our case is going to be the bed spot, which is the 3D model. We can't see it until we are going to set the second layer opacity to 100%. So here it is. And now, to make sure that it respects the alpha channel, we'll change the blending mode from normal to copy. And now we have another instance of the same 3D object rendered using the calculation effect. So we can apply other effects to it, such as I'll go to the generate category and choose the CC light burst effect. I'll click to see the center and I'll move it to somewhere over here to begin with. And then I can play with the intensity and the ray length. So let's set this one to 300 and the ray length to 200. And we can also change the burst options. So I'll select straight in this case. And to see how this looks, my recommendation is to switch off Draft 3D because some of these effects, especially the light burst effect, can really slow down the process using the GPU. So this is how it looks. And as we can see, if I'll switch off this layer, it's actually just going to render the light burst. And as you can also see, it doesn't break the 3D world. However, we have another problem. If I'll move my current time indicator to around 3 seconds, where we can see the Batwing with Batman inside, this Batwing needs to block the light. So luckily, we can use track matte to block the light using the Batwing layer. So all we need to do is just use the track matte peak whip and point it to the relevant layer. So this will be the Batwing. Now, when we are using this option, After Effects is going to switch off the visibility of the track matte layer. So we'll need to turn it back on. And in this case, we need the inverted version. So I'll click over here and this is going to do the trick for us. And now we can see that this light appears behind the 3D model. Now let's just make sure that the light starts at the correct moment. So I'll move my current indicator to 13 frames. I have a bit of experience with this project. And I'll trim the layer to start here by pressing Option or Alt on the Windows and the opening bracket. And then I'll set keyframes for the intensity and the ray length. I'll press U to see those keyframes. I'll move to 1 second and 10 frames. And I'll make sure to add the same values for these keyframes. And then I'll go to where the layer starts and set the intensity and ray length for the CC light burst effect to 0, which means that the light rays will animate across time at the first 1 second of this layer. And to see how this works, I'll go to the beginning and preview the comp. I think it looks great. However, we can improve this by adding an adjustment layer above all the layers and maybe apply some color correction to the entire comp. So I'll pause the playback, I'll close this layer, and then I'll make sure nothing is selected by pressing F2. And then I'll go to the layer menu, and under new, I'll create a new adjustment layer, which is going to be on top of everything. And to this adjustment layer from the color correction category, I'll apply the Lumetri color effect. And let's just move our current time indicator to around 4 seconds where we can see the hero shot and then open up the basic correction. I think I'll raise the exposure just a touch to 0.5. I don't want it to be too dark, although this is the dark night. And I'll open up the creative and I'll just rely on a built-in lookup table. So I think I'll go with the SL Bleach HDR, see how this works. Let's give it a moment to process. I'll switch it off and on. And I think it looks great. helping to give this comp even a better, more appropriate character. Now, there's one more cool thing that we can do with 3D objects in After Effects, and this has to do with effects that reference another layer, such as displacement map, vector blur, caustics, or basically any other compound effect that can now use a 3D model layer as a source to create a highly stylized render. Let me give you one example to how you can use this. And to illustrate it, I'll disable the shy switch and go all the way down. And over here, we can see that there is another hidden model here, which is the Superman Lego model. So I'll drag and drop it above the 2D background, and then I'll switch off the light rays layer momentarily so I can turn on Draft 3D, and then I'll switch on the Superman model. And let's just press spacebar and preview from this point onward. And as you can see, we have a version of CK in his Superman suit flying right after the bad guy to assist him with his superpowers. Now, as I already have some superpowers, I can make this Superman invisible, a capability that even he doesn't know that he has. And to make it happen, I'm going to go to the point in time that I can see the Superman layer, and then I'll switch off the visibility for this layer because I will render it using another layer. So I'll go back to the adjustment layer. We can actually use this to help us with the effects. To it, I'll apply from the distort category the displacement map effect. And then for the displacement map layer, I'll tell it to use the Superman Lego 3D model. Now, to see how this works, we'll need to switch off Draft 3D, and then we can play with the maximum horizontal displacement. I'll set this guy to negative 20 and the maximum vertical displacement. So let's raise this one to around 200, maybe 210, and we can have a look at how this render looks pretty impressive. And of course, the displacement now is based on the 3D model. Now, to bring back some of the Superman original texture and colors, we can use the CC composite effect. So this is another compound effect. Again, instead of using calculations, we can use this one. So under channel, CC composite, I'll apply it after the displacement map. I'll set the top layer to use the Superman model, which by default will just render it above everything. But we can change the transfer mode or blending mode if you want to something different. So let's try soft light and see how it mixes with the displacement. And of course, we also have an opacity slider, so we can turn it maybe down to 60%, just so we can enjoy both worlds, the displacement and then the original colors. I'll go to another point just to check how this looks. And I think that we are ready to preview the final composition. So let's go to the beginning, maximize the composition frame, and preview it. And there you have it, a great way to change the mood and melt 3D objects naturally together with the help of an HDRI image, plus a workaround for applying effects to these layers, as well as referencing those 3D objects using compounds effect. So I hope this will help you in your own work. My name is Elan. Thank you so much for sticking until the end, but now I must fly. I need to visit Gotham, Metropolis, and maybe also Smallville. See you next time.